Malcolm, you've had 5 years now to go to the ICA. Mm-hmm. I'd love to hear your thoughts on what do you think about the building? What do you think about the what you encounter there? Tell us a little bit.
Well, first of all, I think it's an incredibly brave enterprise to first foot in that area. I think the Geoff Edgers building is beautiful, and I think it has become a sort of image for the contemporary effort in Boston. We're united, for instance, by the same families of supporters. People who have long supported the MFA now support the ICA, and vice versa. There's a recognition that there is the opportunity for a partnership, however subliminal. There is that there. And to me, the very statement that the ICA made, the boldness, an expression of hope, investment in an area, really, for all of us, is how can you not be brave?
Jill, now you've had about a week to see the new contemporary wing. I assume you've had a chance to see it?
I have.
And
we parted together.
We parted together,
oh,
exactly.
Very good. But tell me about your, you know, sort of your feelings on that wing and what you've seen and where you're impressed, where there are things that you'd like to see in the future.
You know, it's thrilling to me to walk in and see pieces that make my heart sing or touch me both heart and mind. I really particularly loved the Dora Salcedo crib. I love that piece. We have four Salcedos on view right now at the ICA, so I think that Bostonians actually have this tremendous, or visitors to Boston, this amazing moment to be able to see one of the great great artists of the 20th, 21st century to be introduced and then actually have the opportunity to maybe see a little bit more in depth. I mean, you know, we are so blessed in Boston, right? We have these great museums in the great Encyclopedic Museum of the MFA, the great research institution at Harvard, and the treasure of the Gardner Museum. And for starters, we have probably one of the most important collections of painting in the world, yeah, between these three institutions, and drawings, I would say, prints and drawings as well. It's extraordinary. And it was really interesting, so, to see the contemporary work in counterpoint to the great treasures that we'd just seen unveiled, a year ago, right?
Just a year ago
in the American Wing.
Yes. And so, you know, one of the things I want to do is stimulate discussion. I don't expect Jill to come to the MFA and like everything on our walls, just as the students at the School of the Museum of Fine Arts. I hope they'll see things that inspire them, the things that make them question, and things that they'll rebel against. But the idea really is to engage people and get this discussion going.
Right. I mean, contemporary art, by and large, doesn't answer questions. It tends to provoke them. And I think that is, in fact, what you've done. You've shown us the work of some extraordinary artists, provoked a lot of questions, placed contemporary art in the context of an encyclopedic museum, filled a gap that we've, as I said, we've been so long awaiting, dreaming of, company. Yeah. Dreaming of some company, and bring attention to contemporary art that the ICA, we're a modest-sized institution. I mean, you know, I'll just say, you know, it's a thrill. I mean, Malcolm is the director of one of the greatest museums in the world. It's a great thrill for all of us. We have a different job to do, and we have a lot of overlap and we have a lot of distinction. We focus on a small period of time. We don't focus on all of time. So we tend to be able to go in depth, whereas an encyclopedic museum, they're going to give us some broader strokes about what matters. But what the MFA and the ICA together can do, along with all of our colleagues, is elevate public consciousness about the relevance, the beauty, the discomfort of the work of our time.